Yeah. Got it, got it. Thank you. Thanks for the information. Good morning, my wonderful friends all around the world. There are a lot of friends who have joined me from around the world, but this broadcast is mainly meant for my friends in Northeast India, and especially the place I was born and bred till my early 20s. And that place is called a state called Nagaland, to the extremes of Northeast India. A beautiful place. A wonderful place. With loving and lovable people who likes to live their own life. The traditional values kept, but there have been massive changes in that society wherein the entire society, with the reasons behind, has gone into a negative feel. And this negative feel was not just developed in a day, or in a week, or in a month, or in a year. It has been pumped into their mind for 2 to 2.5 decades. And this is where I do not blame the Nagas below 50 years of age for their massive negativity in seeing anything negative, because they've been fed with this negativity, and that negativity keeps going, multiplying, because now the negative energy of thousands and thousands are just smashing out from their body and mind, wherein even the newborn baby has almost transformed totally into a negative thought. I don't blame them. This has been deliberately done, very deliberately done by their own people who had and have vested interest. Very deliberately done. In another video of mine, I told you all that I had hired a professional dictative team, or the so-called investigation team, based in Bombay, what we call Mumbai, in 2015, and they were there for many, many a month, nearly a year. And they were there with me during my visit, during the present political uprise, wherein the present Chief Minister, Mr. Tiarzaliang, came back to the chair. Cunningly, they were there with me. And I have got a very detailed report of this highly professional team who designated them, they are trained for it, designated them themselves as haircutters in saloons, tea makers in small tea shops, even up to the extent of becoming somebody like what we call in Nagaland Deshwalis, the head loading team. They designated themselves as journalists. They designated themselves as a tourist, roaming around the entire Nagaland for 1 year, a group of more than 18 people. I have a massive, a huge report of 382 pages of the detailed changes that Nagaland went through after the mid-80s. Of course, this hiring of these people, though I've made it public now, they are no more there, was known by only one person, and that was my little brother, Boshe Wamuzo, who is no more. Because I wanted him to know, because he's my little brother. And he was, all these people were in touch with him, and they were in touch with him, me. Very often, whenever they don't get me, they get in touch with my late brother, Boshe Wamuzo. He's the only one who knew that such a group was working there from June 2015 to April 2016, continuously, day and night. They left that place, gave me a report by August 2016. A total report, though they were reporting to me totally. And with my travels in between, many of the travels that I did were known to people. Many were not known. Even the recent travel when Tier Liang and Nephew Rio joined up in Kaziranga, when even the local medias of Nagaland never knew about it. Don't think that I am trumpeting. And I'm no more afraid of negative comments coming up in my social media by anyone, because my social medias are open to all. And if anyone comments negatively, the people of the world will read them. So I'm no more afraid of any negative comments that come up by those totally immature people who do not take my words to the logical terms, but because they were fed, as I told you, with negativity from the time of nearly two and a half decades. Some of the people want to keep that negative mentality spreading, bombarding negative energy on social medias of the closed groups of Nagaland. Though I am totally in support of the total integrity of the Nagas all over the world, I am today, and I always talk of the geographical state that exists, Nagaland, and the people of Nagaland. Because the other issue is not an issue now. The other issue was never an issue when the federal government of Nagaland was formed, way back, even during the British rule. When the man I call Apuza grandfather, Pizo, because I'm very close to that village called Khanna, too close. I am too close to some villages of Nagaland. Another village is Viswama. And I know very well why 90% of the Nagas of Nagaland, except one tribes, do not actually support integrity. Today's topic that I'm touching is one of the most sensitive issues of the entire Northeast. Not only of the Northeast, of the country even. The illegal Bangladeshi Bengalis that has been infiltrating India from the year 1971. A massive issue. And now the infiltration through these people of the ISI has been highly reported by the RO and the Intelligence Bureau of the Defense of India, wherein the ISI group has infiltrated to that loving land that I love from the depth of my heart, the place I was born and bred, Nagaland. A danger that hangs all around Northeast India, and a very potential danger that is hanging today on the land that I was born and bred. I am not going to go into the details of why this negative effect of the people of Nagaland, especially below the age of 50, has come into effect. But I will, excuse me for a minute. sorry for the interruption because I had a very important visitor who wanted to catch me up with some news. And the news is nothing, which I will be coming out, is that of that so-called peace treaty or accord that was signed by the showman of India, Mr. Narendra Modi, to fool the entire people of Nagaland and the entire people of India. I'll come out with the report that has been just handed over to me by, sent to me through an envoy by a friend of mine in Delhi. The foolishness of all this have in fact made my loving Nagas totally negative, wherein they have forgotten themselves. They have actually developed that negativity that they do not believe themselves and they believe nobody. This is a big danger. ISI, as I told you, perfectly clear reports that the ISI has infiltrated into the Northeast India and other country, other states of India through Bangladesh. And they have infiltrated into Nagaland recently when the Bangladeshis in Burma had problems. The ISI has used this as a weapon or a route to infiltrate into Nagaland even. Why I am telling you this is don't take it as just a joke that you all are armed, that every house of Nagaland boast of a gun. Even my house has it. But those guns will be useless in front of the highly trained suicide bombers of the ISI. Those negative feelings of yours, and if somebody is laughing at what I'm saying, write and keep. And it has been proved all over the world. Even the mighty America was nothing in front when America was attacked. The French were nothing in front of them. What is Nagaland then in front of them? What is Assam in front of them? They are highly motivated, suicidal team. Highly equipped. Highly financed. How many thousands and thousands of rupees, counterfeit notes are going around in Northeast India is unimaginable. So is the case in Nagaland. The group that I hired had more than 18,000 rupees of counterfeit note, which they exchanged with their money in buying food and other things. But they were smart enough to keep it, to show me, and then burn it off. It's not a small joke anymore. You cannot handle it with force and power, but you have to use your brains. And I don't say Nagas do not have brains. They really have brains. But those brains that can be used are mum. And those brains that are used are totally negative. Today, the underground, I have video clippings. The underground uses the Bangladeshi Bengalis to take money from you. Taxations, collect taxations. Who can challenge me if I am wrong? I have video clippings in Kohima, in Dimapur. In Chemukudima, what Chemukudima, even Waka, going to the Pandukanwala in Waka and collecting the tax for the UG, a Bangladeshi Bengali. This is a grave issue. And the other day, a mentally retarded aged woman of 60 was raped by two lower than, you cannot call them animals, because animals are much more sensible. Animals do not intercourse with their own siblings. Animals do not go intercourse with a mad animal of theirs. So you cannot call them animals. They're worse than that. And there are no words to put up that. And the entire Naga started blasting on social medias and other things that the IB should be smashed and driven out. The ultimatum of 30 days given to the district administration of Zunhaboto district. Here is what I question you of. What do you expect of the government officials and the government bureaucrats of making a witchcraft lady called Gethilu being made the Rani of Nagaland, who went underground to kill Zapu Pizzo, the man behind the Nagaland freedom fight. And today, that man is being ignored, and a witchcraft woman made the Rani of Nagaland. What do you expect from a government who did this? And the entire Nagas of Nagaland who kept quiet. where there are big-time politicians, even the ministers of the present scenario, the big-time bureaucrats, the retired chief secretaries, the retired principal secretaries. I am not going to name them. Those on the chair and off the chair now, top-level politicians and bureaucrats, and of course, common men like me and my other friends and brothers. Keep totally mum. Not a word comes out of their mouth. Keep totally mum. Even they all kept totally mum to make a witchcraft lady outside Nagaland, the Rani of Nagaland, the entire 60 MLAs, I mean 59 MLAs kept quiet. Some boom boom blast blast on the social media, finished. I can expect, and the rest of the Nagas went silent. I can expect, I can very well expect with my 382 pages of report, plus my intense travelings in the last 4 years into the villages of Nagaland. I never concentrated myself in Kohima and Dimapur. I just stay there for 1 or 2 days and move off. To the depths of Mon, to the depths of the borders of Mokokchung, Chuinsang, Mon, to the depths of the Agami area. I went through because I wanted to rediscover my land. Not because I want to see these places. I've already seen that 30 years back before I left the place. Not because I'm a fool to say that I will be the chief minister of Nagaland like some idiots coming on the closed and secret groups of the Naga social media. Not like some fool who comments or writes a letter on the social media to T.R. Zeliang the other day stating that Mr. Play has been reinstated and you did not come to know the people. Mr. Play has never been thrown out. He can never be thrown out unless there is an ordinance from the government of Nagaland, because he has been appointed by a special ordinance, not only he, by the government of Nagaland. I'm not a fool. I might act like a fool. And I'm a psychologist, a technocrat psychologist, personality development trainer, and I know how to handle people. Put a cap on my head and put 2 glasses on my face to attract people. I know. I know. Go sit in the local booth joint with the booze freaks, and I mean the real booze freaks, not those boozers. And then get the real information of the society they live in. I know, and I've done it many times. I and my daughter were in the hornbill last time. Both my daughter and me, we were keenly observing every word that we were interacting with lots and lots and lots of people. It's not that we wanted to see the hornbill. We wanted to know the realities that are going on. That is because her father wanted to know the realities, knowing very well that her father is not going to stay in Nagaland, knowing very well that her father is not going to be the leader of Nagaland. Knowing very well that her father does not need even a glass of water for free, because his forefathers have made enough for him. Not his father and mother, who made nothing. Gave entire scenario their life for the Nagas. And spoiled my life also. Making me born there, but I love that people and that land. What do you expect from a government that made a witchcraft lady the Rani of Nagaland? And converted that Gethiliu who went underground to kill Pizzo? Go into the history. To kill Pizzo. And because of that, she was called a Rani by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who is a sweet talker and a wonderful sweet talker who really knows how to take women into his pocket. And Nagas outside Nagaland made a religion, Hindu Haraka movement, the indigenous religion of Nagaland. If one Naga can tell me that, even one Naga was a Hindu, I will shave half of my mush and this and walk around naked in front of the people of Nagaland. You can do anything to me. Stone me like the ancient this thing, or hang me like what you did on March 5th. The Nagas were animist, not Hindus. They worshipped nature and the power of nature. And a small group of the Zalyango tribe made a movement called Raka, which has been married to Arasas, now threatening the Nagas. I have come out with a massive write-up which was been flying around the world, though the Naga social media did not understand the impending dark cloud that is hanging on top of you because of the Haraka Arasa's marriage. What do you expect from that government and the people who kept quiet when she was made the run? I expect because you all kept quiet for that wonderful thing to happen. And I expect, and it will not be a surprise for me, if you all, the government and the bureaucrats, make a Bangladeshi Bengali as a Raja. And all of you will keep quiet. As a Raja, and all of you will keep quiet. You have dug a pit. That is becoming your own grave. Nothing more, nothing less. You have dug a pit. That is becoming your grave today. Nothing more, nothing less. No non-local came and dug the pit for you. No plane, no tin two came and dug the pit for you. You dug it yourself. And now it's the grave of yours. You did it yourself. Don't blame anyone. There are millions of tin twos, millions of places all around the world. There are tens of thousands of places in Kerala. Though Kerala is the most lowest corrupted place, we have corruption. But it is the lowest in the entire country because people make the government accountable. They will stop the minister on the road. Get out of your vehicle. Answer us and go. They are there. They will do that. The biggest Christian convention that is just 10 kilometers away from my place. It was the biggest in Asia, but today it is the biggest because Billy Graham convention is no more. Biggest Christian convention that starts a week before the Lent. And ends on the day the Lent starts, one total week. The Maraman convention. Even the chief minister come and sit there. He just sits. Like an ordinary person, nothing more than that. Not even announce that the chief minister of Kerala is there. I'm not joking. There are lords and lords of Nagas coming to the north, not only Nagas, northeast Indians coming for the convention every year. So we don't care about all these people. Though corruption is there. The irony is, as my friend, my little brother said, the irony is that the status of IBI is not stamped on their head. Written on their forehead for people to identify. In fact, most illegal ones come from Assam. Mainly Karimganj, learns the Assamese language, gets all their papers, like residence certificate. After the residence certificate, the election ID card, then open and get a bank account, then get a PAN card, and get another. Once a person has all these, there is nothing more left to prove that These people are Bangladeshi immigrants. Thanks to many corrupt government officials and gamburras, contractors, politicians with vested interest. Yesterday, a girl called me up, a young girl. A very young girl called me up. Her name is Holivi Yathomi. She's on my Facebook. Sir, I've been listening to your videos and everything. I said, what's your name, little one? So my name is Holivi. So I just typed Holivi on my social media to find out who this woman is. And I found out, I asked her, are you Holivi Asumi? Zimomi? She said, Holivi Yathomi, is your profile so and so? Yes, sir. I just liked your profile and I was just thinking, why do you look like a Bengali? She told me a big story about this thing. Very sad. Today morning she called me and told me the entire history of her family. The Gamburas traveled to Silchar and other places for business or something of that sort. Her father's parents died. And one of the Gambura brought him to Mappu. No, Zunhaboto. His brother adopted him as their own son, verbally. Her mother was abducted at the age of 4 and a half. That she did not tell me yesterday. And she is in Zunhaboto. She wants me to help her to get the tribal certification. She does not know, nor her mother knows why she was abducted. Kidnapped. What? 4 and a half years taken up. I'm using Nagamis in between so that my people understand me more. They are nowhere. Flying in the air. They do not know whether they are Nagas, whether they are Bengalis, whether they are Indians. They have everything. Adhar card, Gidhar card. Their mother also has land. But this girl is a little smart enough. Seeing all this IB issue, she told me, sir, I advise her something. And this is where I'm coming. Nothing is put on the head, stamped as IB. Now the only thing they need is an ILP, inner line permit. To enter Nagaland, which is always available for any Tom, Dick, and Harry with fees. When I left Nagaland, it was not available. Stringent rules were applied, even the army used to check it. So So you had the Deshwalis, what we call the Deshwalis, the Biharis, and from UP. Why you call Deshwali is when one Bihari or a UP guy meets another UP guy, he calls his friend, "Are you Deshwali? Deshwali, my landman, are you Deshwali?" That is called Deshwali, Deshwali. In the Vishuddha Namdo, Deshwali Laga. It is not created dead, that is what created Deshwali. So again, as they enter Nagaland, the colony chairman, please give a residential certificate, since the newcomer is known to an old timer whom he is familiar with, and with which a driving license is quickly made. Backdoor agents. Thanks again to the corrupt transport officers, wherein even Kerala has the national permit vehicles registered in Nagaland flying here. NL1, NL2, NL3, flying here. National. They don't even see the vehicle. Permit is issued, registered, and permitted is issued. Money. You've dug your own grave. Once the driving license is made, a permanent address proof is available to even apply for a job. You have dug your own grave. Listen intensely or rewind this video after the video is finished and listen intensely of whatever I said. Analyze it. Don't just comment and put it on your private, closed, secret, super secret Naga groups on the social media, which I've left totally. People keep adding me. I left. I keep leaving. Because it's like talking, sitting in a closed room. No use. With all negative impacts. Why? Recently, I came out with the place issue. Because I got screenshots from all this and I came out with play. It's just an end in Kerala. You've made him a cosmic thing in Nagaland. Even my auto rickshaw fellows call him a pimp. Listen to the video that I put up. Aya Achaya. Achaya means a respectable way of calling. Achaya. Idu police, dangor dangor police officer khanla, maikila, idu malish kuri digna, tai SP hoi jaishe. Tadela minister khan, chief minister khanla, sob palbara malish kuri digna, duri digna dishe. Poisa de yate ponjishe, tai khanla, poisa yate ponjishe, tai bhi poisa. Aru sabina yete dotala gore naga manugan gore safa kori diya je tai labi safa kori diya je shoram nai to gan toi gan ai bila kotha koye je toila manugan ke photaye je তাহলে অপকর সাফ করি বলে শরম নেই? কবি না নেগেটিভ জলি কোন আছে? জলি লা পিছে দে কি আছে? নিজলা গ্রেভ দিক করি কিনা রাখি কিনা মানুষকে ব্লেম গেম। ইউ বিন প্লেইং গেম ব্লেম গেম ফর দ্য লাস্ট 20-25 ইয়ার্স, হোয়াট হ্যাভ ইউ গেইনড? ইন দ্য এন্ড ইউ ডোন্ট ইভেন হ্যাভ দ্য ন্যাশনাল হাইওয়ে ফিনিশ গন। It takes 6-8 hours to reach Kohima to Dimapur. You went 3 days with dead body, ho 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 ho, burned everything and went there. Tears jaleng naile murai diwo. Tears jaleng to sab manela pokor mari digine itia bohi ase. If you read sob manula pokor mari diya. Don't think that I'm using all these dirty words, because I am, in fact, I'm ashamed to say that I was born and brought up in that wonderful place with that wonderful, lovable, loving people. How low can you go? How low can you become? I left Aam Aadmi Party. I will tell you the, on another this thing. The official spokesperson, Leng Wang Konyak, has brought out another witchcraft lady from Konyak tribe to make her another Rani. Prophecies. He is the spokesman. Fooled many of you, and I know it perfectly well. I went to Mon to find out his history. I asked that person who was the convener of the party, what is all this about fooling an Angami girl? I sent my auntie-like figure to find out to her. Everything is true. And this, I don't know whether he is still the convener. Amos Longcomer. He said the lady came back and gave the gifts, a ring and this thing and all, and he threw it off, it seems. The vested interest, I found out from the beginning of all this, Amos Longcomer getting ready to go for elections, counting from 2,500 votes already. I begged him, I will count from 2,501 for his failure. With a spokesperson who is coming out with another witchcraft lady, cheating the Naga girls, and this man supporting him. Dimapur too, I bet him. Jolly Kaimanil. Matthew Peter officially bet him. He is counting from 2,500 watts. I will count from 2,501 watt for his failure. So, what I'm trying to say is that most Bangladeshis who entered Nagaland has all documents in order. The only effective way to drive them out peacefully is to go the way Mizoram went. many of the Nagas blame the Semas. Blame them again. For adapting, for doing that, for doing this. Yeah. There are facts in it. But you're still playing the game, the blame game. You have not realized that the blame game that you have been playing for 2.5 decades have reached you nowhere. Instead, you have gone. Your nose, tip of your nose has already touched the ground. And it's about to go inside the dust. To be forced to breathe the dust to keep yourself alive. The blame game. The Nagas do not want to work. Only government jobs. They will not work. Showroom also though. Graduate hoise. Class 10 pass hoa. Graduate hoise. Chila graduate. Kote laga graduate. One Aam Aadmi fellow. He called me, he became the first enemy of mine. He called me and said, sir, I want a certificate of a computer or anything so that I can get the benefits of the Nagaland government. Ene dibo moi la manu aje sema ene dibo moi la manu aje. I said, my boy, this is Kerala. You don't get all this foolishness here. And I am not into all that. He went against me. The first person who started spitting at me. Another fellow, Vikhato Aye, when I came to know that he was doing his proxy work for his own brother who is a leader. Totally against me. Boom. Stamp bomb mari di dishoto matta de. Ki joli to chor raje tade bara ao khala ater amos longkumar la ghor bara chor kuri kina jaise sala taila ghor wadene kandigina mai ke phone kuri. I didn't tell anyone that mui kandigina moila friend na hoile moila nijor brother. I'm telling you, so that you all realize. The SP, I called him up. I told this Amos Longkumar, you know, I have already introduced you to the SP. You call him up. Sir. Halbara. I phoned him up from outside my house. And told the SP, who is a brother to me, younger brother, told him such and such thing happened. He immediately called the commissioner of Dimapur, who rushed the police to his house. There's Vikhato Aye, who went to his house early in the morning, even after my aunties reached from Patkai. Before them, they reached. Amos Longkumar's house. And Amos Longkumar kept quiet. Smashed on the social media. Jolly, sure, Amos Longkumar, you have the power to ask Jolly to return all to the matter. Being a human being, I felt very bad. But it did not even touch a hair of mine. I realized later when the people started following me in hundreds. He branded me as alcoholic. He didn't know that my social media said that I used to drink heavy. But I've never drunk with anybody. drank with anybody, sorry. And I've never been drunk. And I don't drink now. That does not mean I'm a Pentecost. I might drink more. Okay. These are the guys who are going to take Ahmadni Party to the topmost. The fellow went and I will come to all this, went for the fuel adulteration case negotiated by the time. 45 minutes negotiation. I came to know. By the time account reached there and he could not get the money. So he challenged me. He could not get the money because account reached there before that. These are the guys who are going to take you to new glories. Only way you can do this is by brain. Now, let me ask you something. The IB issue started from 1971. My friend, my same age, or elder to me, Bengalis, their parents or their grandparents came to Nagaland. They served the people of Nagaland. Their children, their grandchildren are there. How do you identify them and say that they are illegal? What right do you have to say? Ever do you have to say that when you say that the Nepalis are illegal? You tell me, answer me. You tell that the Manipuris who are there are legal. Because the Garos are from the Assam state and they are tribals. You say they are legal? What difference is there between those indigenous Nepalis, Garos and these Bengalis who came there way back in the early 40s, 50s, 60s, before the 70s. What right do you have to question them? Tell me. I'm not joking. How can you identify this? The guns that go, they have massive guns. Let me tell you, people were laughing when that Bangladeshi, the big man of ASU, Muhammad, what blah, something. ASA, not ASU, ASSA. Got all the Naga Students Union into his pocket and gave admissions to the poor Naga children all over UP and the stupid colleges around the country, promising them that the tribal funds will be transferred to them. And the Naga Students Union people made their money because they collected money from all the students. And this Asa who got this money also bought a bolero for one leader of the Eastern Union for helping him to bring out those people who were arrested in Dimapur hotel. And he kept you all on ransom when you finished the March 5th scenario. Nobody there. The NSF. Poi khai shudo. But the NSF was too powerful to give a statement on the media of Nagaland, calling me to their office to explain why I helped the Naga children. When I used the exact name of the ex-president of NSF, Ozukum. When I perfectly said, not the entire this thing, group. Whereas there was the general secretary. Good. He kept you on ransom on the floor for the incident of 5th March, and later on all the children were thrown out. He ate his money. Ulai jaishe. Pogode marigina. Phal paido tu khanna itue. Moi tu sida sida koile to bia paido. Nagle tajigna koi bhi bia paido. You try using your weapons. I'm telling you, the ISI will smash you on the streets of Dimapur. They'll bombard you. Use your brains. I will give you a solution, the best solution. The Nagas don't work, but they give their houses for rent. Phal pai na ekta room dile dosta room banai dile to hoishe to life. Dukan banai degi na dile mera naam de dukan chalai degi mujhe dosta ka dibi aru tax bhi di dibi de mera rent bhi dibi aru mera dosta ka bhi dibi aru tax bhi di dibi. Maybe I na pani puri khabo toi laga pishab puri na dalile bhi mui khai logo ekuno ekuno ido pishab puri ido free bora anu mui ido government job piche bora pai logo anu itu bhi bikri puri na dusra manu ke di na mui pade koi na itu khai logo ekuno mui Great, Jason. Immaniche Jason. Are the government of India, central government, get blame Korea? Chile, I can puisa digra muike and get inika kuridisha. Now the this thing, the underground is coming with another great thing. The accord. The IM is coming with another great thing, that there will be an interim government with the old communist constitution. you will not even have the right to cut even one tree of yours. Write and keep. I might die tomorrow. If it happens, I'll try. I am trying and I will try my best. And there are people in Nagaland who know that. They have been with me for my meetings in Pune and Ahmedabad and all. They know. I will be the first man to cut that. And I'm trying. That is which will destroy Nagaland forever. And I don't want to see that land and the people suffering. I don't know. I'm not going to gain anything from all this. The only thing I gain is all that stupid people like Bikato, Kikato and all spitting at me on the social media. But I gain something whenever I tell somebody that is my land. I was born and bred a wonderful place. That is what I gain. The only thing I give. Because my parents get a little pension, that's all, from the government of Nagaland. That is not even sufficient for their medicines. My mother is suffering from bone marrow cancer. 5,000 rupees because her treatment is done in RCC. The same injection costs 18,000 to 20,000 outside. 5,000 per week. Their pension is not enough for that. So I don't even take that 1 rupee from them. So I don't expect anything from that. The only thing I'm going to gain is this. So my suggestion is this. Stop. Start working. Start your businesses. Take back your businesses. That you are giving to all these people. Start running it. It might run on a loss. Business is not easy money tomorrow. It is money after time. I am also a business. 26 years, very successful business. There are Nagas who came here, stayed in my house. There are Naga children who come and go because I am their guardian, official guardian. They know. Business is not tomorrow's money. It is a money that comes later on in life. Take back your businesses. Give them out. Employ them as your business guys. Don't give your houses for rent. Put them in one colony if you're giving rent. Don't issue any certification to them. Not a single certification. Cancel the entire certifications. Entire, I mean entire. The people of Nagaland have to come out onto the streets. I'm telling you, it is the doomsday of yours, the dark cloud. That dense dark cloud is coming down day to day, minute by minute. The RSS Heraka group is invading you heavily with T.R. Zeliang as the patron of the Heraka movement of Nagaland. That is why the RSS chief, your governor, and the RSS group that is on rule in the center, ones here sitting on the chair. Vajpayee's group was not run by RSS, but this is run by total RSS, with their headquarters in Jalukipuram in Nagaland. Go check it out. Nephew Rio, the BJP guy, trying his level best. And that witchcraft woman who has been declared as your Rani Maharani, her people in the underground coming into Nagaland through the IM to rule you. Put all this together, the doomsday, the dense dark cloud is coming down, which I forecasted or wrote more than 2 years back. It's coming down and down and down to crash you forever. You will be made slaves by your own people. You will be made slaves by the people these guys used, the Bangladeshi Bengalis. To take money from you, to bribe you, to work for you, and to screw you upside down. Only way to come out of this is use your brain. Take back the businesses that you have handed over to them to make easy money. Don't give any more rental places to anyone. Don't force them out of your rental houses. That is inhuman again, in many cases. But shift them out, put them off in areas where they are themselves. Monitor them. Cancel the entire certifications, the entire ration cards, the entire inner line permits, the entire driving licenses, the entire other cards, the entire banking accounts from 1997. Then, as a good friend, the editor, chief editor of 3MM said, Mr. K. Temjan Jamir said on our group yesterday, timely and legal move. Cancel all this. Take the legal action of deporting these people out. Then see the wonder. Then see the wonder. Seal your boundaries. Warn your Gamburas that if you come to know even one Gambura or one colony chairman doing something funny, you blabber about Section 371. Warn them that the people will take the customary law into hand. Can you do that? Show me if you can do that. Then I will call you real Nagas. Not doing what you did on March 5th and other incidences where you degrade yourself to the entire world. Show me this, what I have told you and what Temjan and my younger brothers, we discussed yesterday on the group very intensely. Can you do this? Force the government. Stop the entire function of the government. You have deteriorated to the lowest point. Let all the government offices be shut. But don't do like last time, 3 days and then go off. Let all the government offices be shut. Let not even the private scenarios move. Let the markets be open for the common man. Not a single vehicle, not even the private vehicles of the big people in the offices or the government should play. No violence. No need of violence. No need at all. Shut the entire. And it was a very, very wonderful way the Mogok Chung District Students Union did. Timely and phased manner of eliminating them. Beautiful example. This is not the time to play tribalism. When you're dying, you're already dying in all ways, not one way. The IBI one, the RSS Haraka one, the underground peace accord that brings in the Haraka heads on top of you with the communist, total old communist constitution, another massive. And enter wonderfully, beautifully corrupted 60 MLAs that you keep on sending on top. You are already dying. Muriaze. Last time gane utibi. At least bacha khan ke leave kuribo dibi na. Born today, they can't laga phavi bhi. Baki to ekhen phavi ye phava nai do. 2 or 20 years, 25 years today, to ekhen to phava bhi phava nai. Paisa di thagi she, mobile kini kina di thagi she, gari di thagi she, itu di thagi she, itu di thagi. Phava bhi phava nai do na. At least. আজি তো ভাবি না আজি জনম হওয়া বাচ্চা খান লাগা ভাবিবি তো এখানে মুড়ি আছে মুড়ি আছে মুড়ি আছে মুড়ি আছে অলপ টাইম আছে মুড়ি বলে when I say you are dying it's equivalent to death ভাবিবি ইতিয়া Stop the entire, destabilize the entire government. Sit at home. Everybody sit at home. Let the schools, colleges, everything be closed. Everything. Let the poor people go to the markets. Don't stop. The supplies to come in. Don't starve the people. Let them be free walking, not a single vehicle except emergency vehicles to the hospitals. Except to the hospitals. and for marriages. Let them write a board on the vehicle and keep, like we have during the bans and hatals in Kerala. Shut down the entire state. Cover the boundaries. Shut down the entire state. You don't need any violence. One, the final warning to all the politicians, to all the gamburas, to all the colony chairmen, that the voters list will be scrutinized by the group and find out that the voters list has only the names of the legal people after 1971. Can you do this? Can you do this? If you can do this, I will call you a Naga. Or else, I would be very sad to say, you are all just Nagas by name. And you have degraded the entire Nagas, the old generation Nagas. If you can't do this, তুই কেন মরি আছে ইতিয়া করিবি না করিলে মই তুই কব নাম কারণে তুই কেন নাগা আছে এক্স্যাক্টলি লাইক মুহাম্মদ জিমোমি অর Lakshmi Jamir, all the Nagar Nagas. Aru to ikhan do idu bura buri Naga manukhan who are now 80, 70, 80 years old, 80, 90 years. Taikhan la nam bibia. Ito po mo. Original Naga manukhan la nam bibia. Ito po mo. So, my dear friends, in Kerala, if we have plenty of Bangladeshis because we Keralites have already spread out to the entire world. They go for job or anything. So we have labor problems and all these Bangladeshis and other ones. Or I don't know whether they are Bangladeshis, but we don't care for them. They come forward. They go. They cannot even get a small certification. Forget about anything else. Bank account, impossible. Nothing. They have to report to the police station. They have to produce their job. I mean, working part. The contractors are responsible for that. You work, get out. That's it. We don't let them stay in our residential areas. Mm-hmm. We don't let them stay in our where our people stay. No. Yeah, in colonies, we don't care for them. The police is there to look. The law is there to look after them. Why can't you do that? Why can't you do that? You need cheap laborers. I agree. Keep them as laborers. As in this program, my suggestion of this is reclaim all your businesses. Underline as I wind up this program. Reclaim all your businesses. Employ those who are in business were doing as your employees. Don't order them. As your employees, pay them their salary, decent salary. Slowly shift those rental houses to areas where they have scenarios. Start doing the works, employ the Nagas, Nagas start doing work. Don't sit at home. Go. Dig like the Bangladeshis dig. Drive like the Bangladeshis drive. I used to drive my tourist buses for 9 days. 8 days, 9 days. You ask my people here. My cousins and brothers are watching. I'm a technocrat. I have everything, you see. But when my drivers come tired, I do not put my tie and say, take the vehicle and go. As a driver, drive, dig. Work with the contractors who are on the national highway contract, who are on the other things. Go. Sell momos on the street. Stop eating panipuri. And shut down the entire administration. Till they cancel the entire certification from 1971. The entire certification. Not one should be spared. All the certifications and the bank accounts cancelled. From 1971. Then take legal actions of deporting them from your state. I will call you a perfect Naga. Pull the entire government down. Select a group. Let it go to the level where if the IM and the government of India, the showman Narendra Modi, does not publicly publish the peace treaty or blah, nothing is going to happen in Nagaland. Shut it down. Except the hospitals and the provisions. Shut the entire lot down till you get it. And I will call you Naga. If not, I myself, a man of full-hearted Naga with Kerala blood and brain, will call you a Naga by namesake. Exactly like Muhammad Zimomi and Priyanka or Sharmila Jamir, who are deliberately out to put a disgrace to the Nagas who were alive and are alive. Those who are alive, maybe 80 years plus. Grave situation. You are being cornered from every side. The IB issue, the Haraka RSS, the IM with the Haraka movement of Maharani coming in. Check it. You're going to have it. The time is up, my dear. You're going to be slaves under your own people. And I'm saddened by all this, what is happening. I shall be coming out with the entire report of my starting Aam Aadmi Party till the day I left Aam Aadmi Party. And why? I will be the biggest enemy of Aam Aadmi Party in Nagaland. and dear Zeliang and nephew Rio will be second enemy to me, because I want to stop the young corrupted people coming from in the name of Ahmad. And I have clear proofs. I don't talk just like that. Clear-cut proofs of all that, including the spokesman Leng Wang fooling all lot of women, the Angami women, including the audio clipping of the so-called convener. I don't know whether he's the convener. Amos Longkumar stating that Leng Wang, a lady who came to his house and gave him the engagement ring and other things, and he threw it out. I have all that. Everything. And I'll be the biggest enemy of these people who negotiated in the fuel adulteration case but could not get the money, because by the time Akot reached there, my I called up the court. Yeah. I came to know this. That Vikado is already in the petrol pump negotiating. My brain. I'm not joking. I'll be coming out with that tomorrow, same time, 10:30. Till then, my usual programs at 7:30 p.m. will continue every day, every night. Thank you. Catch you up. God bless you. And this time, I believe from my heart, from the depth of my heart, that the entire Nagas will come out on the streets, shut the entire government administration till all your demands are fulfilled. I'm with you. And I'll be writing a note of what I think you have to do. Take care. Have a wonderful afternoon. And stay blessed. Stay happy. Stay safe.
Yeah.